Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I want to welcome you to yet another edition of our online lesson. This is Islamic College Oshobo, and the topic, the subject is chemistry, SS3. We will continue today with our solution to our mock examination. Today we are going to look at the practical examination. Hopefully, by the end of the lesson today, we would have looked at the solution to question one. Question one, like you are already aware, is volumetric analysis, which the question is displayed on your screen, as you can see. You have solutions A and B, which contain A contains 0.01 mole per dm cube, solution of triosulfonated 5-acid, and solution B is prepared as shown in this question. 10 cm cube solution of saturated potassium tricarbonate 4 was prepared at 25 degrees Celsius was diluted to 100 cm cube, and solution A was put into the burette and titrated against 20 or 25 cm cube proportion of solution B. Like you are aware, at in our own situation here, we use 25 cubic centimeter of pipette. So it means solution A was titrated against 25 centimeter cube portion of B using methyl orange indicator. Now, the examiner requires you that you should tabulate your readings and calculate the volume of the average volume of A used. And from the results and information provided, we have to calculate the concentration of B in gram per dm cube, in mole per dm cube, the solubility of potassium tricarbonate 4 in mole per dm cube at 25 degrees Celsius, solubility of potassium tricarbonate 4 in gram per dm cube at 25 degrees Celsius, the mass of potassium tricarbonate 4 that will be recovered if 100 cm cube of the saturated solution were cooled from 25 degrees Celsius to 5 degrees Celsius, given that the solubility of potassium tricarbonate 4 at 5 degrees Celsius is 1.25 gram per cubic decimeter. And you are given the equation for the reaction as 2 moles of this to produce this. 2 moles of HNO3 plus 1 mole of K2CO3 to produce KNO3, H2 and CO2. Now, to solving the question. Solution to the question is not far-fetched. The first step is to tabulate the reading. Alhamdulillah, you have been given a table that shows how you are going to enter the results. In tabulating the reading of a titration, the first thing to do is to fill in the necessary information. You have the titration number here, then first titration, second titration, third titration. Sometimes you may precede these ones with a rough titration, so that we have a 4 columns on this side. Then, at the vertical column, final burette reading should be on top. Please take note of that. Initial burette reading should follow that, and the volume of acid used should follow that. And each should be accompanied with the unit, which is cubic centimeter or centimeter cube, as you may like to pronounce it. So this is the first thing you have to do on the table. Without this, your table may not have any value. Then the next thing is to fill in the initial burette reading. In most instances, students use initial burette reading of 0.00 cubic centimeter. And that is when the burette is filled with A up to 0.00 mark. Then the next thing that you have to take note of is that the readings should be to 2 decimal places, as you can see on your screen. So the initial burette reading should be written first. It is after putting the solution into A and titrated against B, whatever you get as your final reading, that you're going to put on top of it. So initial final burette reading on top like that, as you see in the next table. So now, the teacher's value in that particular exam is as shown here. So 12.10 cubic centimeter in the first titration, in the other side titration 12.20 cubic centimeter. Note again that the values are written to two decimal places. The values are written to this number. So the next thing is to subtract the initial budget reading from the final budget reading in each of the cases. And that is what we have here. So 12.10 minus 0.00 in all in each of the cases. 12.20. So the value we get is what we write as volume of acid used or volume of A used, as the case may be. If A is not, it's not acid. It's not in all cases that A will be acid. So if A is not an acid, it will be written as volume of A used. Now note that the reason why most students prefer writing their initial using 0.00 as the initial budget reading is for ease of subtraction, because at the end of the day, initial budget reading will be subtracted from the final budget reading, and that will give us the volume of A used. So if we use different values, any other value other than zero, we have the task of subtracting, and during the process of subtraction, some students are afraid of making mistakes. But if once you have used zero, you know that whatever your final bullet reading minus zero will just give you a straightforward answer. Now, the examiner requires to, the next thing is to calculate the average volume of A used. Before I leave that previous page, this table, according to WAEC standard, carries 8 marks. And you are going to lose mark if you commit certain errors. One, if there is no unit, wherever there you refuse to put unit here, this cubic centimeters that we wrote here, wherever there is no unit, you lose 1 mark each, up to maximum of 2 marks. Two, if you don't write to two decimal places, that we call it inconsistently writing to two decimal places. So each time you fail to write your values to two decimal places, you lose 1 mark each, up to a maximum of 2 marks. Three, if there's any sign that you cancel your figures in order to agree with the supervisor's value or in order to agree with your friend's value, maybe right after performing the experiment, discover that your friend got something different, you cancel your own to agree with his or her own. So if there's any cancellation in your table, you lose 1 mark for each of the cancellation, up to maximum of 2 marks. If you cancel the entire table, you lose 4 marks. You lose 4 marks. For each arithmetic error, that is when you are subtracting the initial budget reading from the final budget reading, each of the calculation error attracts loss of a mark. Then if your value, the total value you eventually get, differs from that of your supervisor, then the supervisor's value, or it is called the value got by your the officer in charge of the equipment or apparatus. If the value differs, then you lose mark accordingly. If your value differs from that of your teacher by difference of 0.15, either more or less, you lose 1 mark each time. The difference of more than 0.15, that is the difference of 0.20, you lose 1 mark, 2 marks each. Difference of 0.25 each, you lose 1 mark each, and so on like that, until some people have no mark in that table. So you have to be careful. So it means what the examiner requires from you is ability to follow instruction, then being accurate, working with accuracy. So please ensure that you always take all necessary precautions during titration. Now, you are required to find the average volume of A used. The average volume of A used is usually 2 marks according to WAEC standard. So 2 marks, it carries 2 marks. So what is required? That choosing two values that are concordant. And how do you know that values are concordant? If the difference between the two values is no more than 0.2, like this value, this is 12.10, this is 12.20. So the difference between them is 0.1, so you see they are concordant. But comparing second titration and third titration, you have the same value. So it is preferred that you use the two values. And it is always preferred that we average two of the values that are closest. So in this case, we are using 12.00 and 12.00. So divided by 2. And that gives us 12.00. Remember, so if the values you use are concordant, you get 1 mark. And if you evaluate correctly with unit, you get another mark, making 2 marks for the averaging of volume of acid used. So that's how it is done. Now, we are required to calculate the concentration of B in mole per dm cube. Now, in that case, we need to go back to the equation. The equation says two moles of transnitrate 5 acid react with 1 mole of potassium transcarbonate 4 to form two moles of transnitrate 5 potassium transnitrate 5 and 1 mole of 1 mole of 1 mole of water and 1 mole of carbon 4 oxide, showing that the mole ratio of acid to base in this reaction is ratio 2:1. So it is written like the CAVA of acid BVB is equal to 2:1. Now note that many of us are fond of writing CAVA of acid BVB is equal to NA over NB, which is correct, but it doesn't earn you any mark because that has not shown that you know what you are doing. So the following step that you follow that is this: you should show us what is that value of number of mole ratio of acid to base, and that usually carries 1 mark. Please don't omit that step if you value the mark. So the next step is to substitute into the relationship. So the CA is 0.01 mole according to the question that we have seen, and VA is the volume of acid used, is the value you get for your table. CB is the concentration of base in mole per dm cube that you are required to calculate, and VB is the volume of your pipette, which in this case is 25 cubic centimeter, is equal to 2:1. So making CB the subject of the equation, you get it like this: 0.01 mole per dm cube times 12.20 cm cube divided by 2 times 25 cm cube, and evaluating that you get 0.2002 mole per cubic decimeter. Now I have told you before that the relationship CAV of acid is VB is equal to 2:1 carries 1 mark. Substituting to correlating to the formula carries another mark. Correct evaluation carries another mark with units. And note the decimal place of the number of decimal places we used here. We use 3 decimal places for concentration in mole per dm cube. Please take note of that. So your concentration should be corrected to three decimal places as shown. Now the next part of the question, you are required to calculate the concentration of B in gram per cubic decimeter. Using the relationship concentration in gram per dm cube is equal to concentration mole per dm cube times molar mass. So the first step is to calculate the molar mass of potassium transcarbonate 4 because that is the content of B, and we have been given in the question that K is equal to 39, C is 12, O is 16. So in this case, we have 39 times 2 plus 12 plus 16 times 3, which is equal to 138 gram per mole. Therefore, concentration of the concentration in gram per dm cube for B is the concentration in mole per dm cube, as we have said, times molar mass, which is 138 gram per mole, and that gives us 0.278 gram per cubic decimeter. So, Roman figure 3. So you are required to calculate the solubility of potassium transcarbonate 4 at 25 degrees Celsius in mole per dm cube. Now in this case, you can see you are required to calculate the solubility. Solubility is actually the concentration of saturated solution, like we are aware. Concentration of saturated solution. If you look at the question well from the top, the question says you have saturated solution of potassium transcarbonate 4. Which you diluted by measuring 10 cubic centimeters of it and diluting it to 100 cubic centimeters. It means initially the solution given to us is saturated. The solution prepared originally is saturated. But we prepared it to get B. So it, so if we now use B for experiments, the value got with that value that you get for B as its concentration mole per dm cube is not the concentration of the solution, saturated solution. So it means saturated solution was rediluted. And so in order to get the concentration of saturated solution, which in other words is the concentration of the which is the, in other words is the solubility of the salt, we have to use dilution theory because we have carried out dilution. And in using dilution theory, we require four variables: initial concentration, that is concentration of the saturated solution, which is the solubility; the volume of saturated solution that was measured, which in this case is 10 cubic centimeters; the concentration of the solution that was prepared from the saturated solution, which we have just calculated as the concentration of B; and then the volume that was prepared, that is the volume that to which the solution was made, which is 100 cubic centimeters. So we have so the initial concentration is called C1, and that stands for the concentration of the saturated solution. The final concentration is called C2, which is the concentration of the of B that was prepared. The initial volume of solution measured is tagged V1, which is the volume of the saturated solution that was measured. The final volume of solution that was prepared, that was is a V2, which is the volume to which the original solution was made. So we have, using the dilution theory, we have C1 multiplied by V1 is equal to C2 multiplied by V2, which as we have it here, original concentration C1 times volume of original solution, which is V1, but is equal to concentration of previous solution C2 multiplied by V2. So I have alerted the many of each of them here for easier understanding. So making C1, which is what is required to be calculated, the subject of the equation, we have C1 is equal to C2 over V2. And C2 is the concentration that we get from our experiments, which is 0.002 mole per cubic decimeter. V2 is the volume of solution prepared, that is 100 cubic centimeter. V1 is the volume of the saturated solution measured, which is 10 cubic centimeter here. So putting those values into the equation, we get this value. So you can try it on your own and see what you are going to get. Now, the next part of the question, that is Roman figure 4. You are required to calculate the solubility of B in gram per dm cube. Now, determine the solubility of B in gram per dm cube, we use the same relationship that we have been using for concentration. That is, solubility in gram per dm cube is equal to solubility in mole per dm cube times molar mass. And solubility in gram per dm cube, solubility in mole per dm cube is what we have just got from our calculation. Molar mass is what we have got before, that's 138 gram per mole. So multiplying the two values, we get 2.76 gram per cubic decimeter. Then Roman figure 5, we are required to calculate the mass of potassium tricarbonate 4 that will be recovered if 100 cubic centimeter of the saturated solution of potassium tricarbonate 4 were cooled from 25 degrees Celsius to 5 degrees Celsius. In doing that, what is just required is to take the higher temperature, determine the solubility of the salt at that temperature, then come to the lower temperature, determine the solubility of the salt at that. In this case, now we have been given the solubility at the lower temperature as 1.25 gram per dm cube. We have calculated the solubility at 25 degrees Celsius as 2.76 gram per dm cube. So subtracting the solubility at lower temperature from solubility at higher temperature, we have 2.76 minus 1.25. The difference in that solubility multiplied by the volume of solution of saturated solution from which we want to recover divided by 1000 will give us the mass of the salt that will be recovered. As we have it here, So difference in the solubilities multiplied by volume over 1,000, volume of saturated solution for 1,000 is what will give us, and that is what we have done here. 100 divided by 1,000 give us 0.1, 2.76 minus 1.25 to give us, will give us 1.51. So 1.25 times 0.1 give us 0.151 gram, and that is the mass of the salt that will be recovered. Please check your assignment portal for your assignments, and please solve the question. When solving the question, compare your steps with the steps used in this calculation so that you would be able to be well guided. I pray Allah grant you better understanding of the lesson and grant you retentive memory. Assalamu alaikum.